Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Kingdom Plantae. In that we are studying topic Pteridophyta. Now pteridophytes are one of the plants of Kingdom Plantae and they are very primitive plants. So let's just study about them. Pteridophytes. Now, if I talk about pteridophytes, they could be said as the most primitive, or you can just simply say they are the most old plants of Kingdom Plantae. They are small-sized annuals or perennials that basically grow well at cold, dampy places. Their body is diploid in nature and the roots of these plants are adventitious. They are never tap root system. Their roots being adventitious, it's very difficult to segregate or differentiate the primary, secondary and tertiary roots. There are a bunch of adventitious roots present. Also, their stem could be aerial most of the time and it is phototropic, or sometimes some part of the stem is beneath the ground, which is also termed as underground. Now the leaves are basically simple leaves. They are never compound leaves. Simple leaves have their petiole and their veins properly arranged in an angle or rectangular fashion. And they're sessile. When I say sessile, they are very delicate in nature and thin. Vascular systems. Now vascular systems are the mechanism to carry food and water, which is xylem and phloem. Both are present. But the xylem has certain differentiation or certain difference in characters. Pteridophyte. Now pteridophytes are basically small sized annual or they could be perennial plants that grow well under damp, shady conditions. One example is ferns, which all of us must have seen. Now pteridophytes, sometimes they are water living, which is aquatic. One of the pteridophytes is Azolla, and sometimes they be desertic kinds, the xerophytic pteridophytes that basically grow on tree trunk. And when they grow on tree trunk, they will obviously obtain their nutrition from that host organism. The plant body in pteridophytes is basically diploid sporophytes, and it is differentiated in your roots, stems and leaf region. Now roots basically in pteridophytes are adventitious, while their stem are aerial or maybe sometimes underground. Now, leaves in pteridophytes are basically aerial and they're compound leaves. Now, compound leaves or this kind of leaves basically have their venates or veinlets in associated forms. The leaves are sometimes simple and sessile also. When I say sessile, they're kind of a weak. And large and pinnately compound leaves or scaly leaves are also present in this pteridophyte family. Now, it depends upon the region where that particular pteridophyte is growing. The type of leaf would be present. If it is, for example, a xerophytic pteridophyte, then pinnately compound leaves and scaly leaves would be present. When it is normal terrestrial pteridophyte, simple leaves will be present. Also, vascular tissue, which is xylem and phloem, are present in pteridophyte, though they are vascular or primitive plant. Whereas vessels are absent in the xylem. Now, vessels were the conducting vessels or tubes in the xylem, while phloem lack companion cells. So we could simply say that maybe xylem and phloem is present in this, but the xylem and phloem is not in so advanced form. That's basically vessels and companion cells are not present. Whereas your normal plants or normal varieties of kingdom plantae, whether it is your gymnosperms, angiosperms, dicots, monocots, will have xylem and phloem with the vascular tissues, that is companion cells and vessels. Students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about pteridophyte, the old vascular plant, which was the oldest plant of kingdom plantae. Now, if you just have a glimpse of kingdom plantae, what did we study was bryophyta, angiosperm, gymnosperms, pteridophyta. And while studying all this, what we could say is gymnosperms, angiosperms, bryophyta had little characteristics which could be terrestrial, and they have better characteristics in the terms of vascular systems, whereas your pteridophytes did not are so developed that they have all the characteristics of vascular systems. Students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about pteridophyta and its qualities and where they are produced and how they have qualities of different plantlets and plant systems. I hope, students, we're very clear with this concept of pteridophyta. Thank you.